Welcome to Eagles Christian Center online service. We believe God has a word for you, so stay tuned and be blessed. Service with Pastor Isaac Machisa. Stay tuned. Leadership 101 is a teaching by Pastor Machisa on personal management. This includes cultivating a better professional image, building self-confidence, how to gain a reputation for honesty and integrity, how to be assertive, and the organizing principle. The faithfulness of God, the unchanging God, are among the teaching that will bless your life. Do get in touch with us. You are still watching our online service with Pastor Isaac Machisa. Stay tuned.
Hello viewers and welcome back to our online service. I believe that last Sunday you were blessed by the word, and we are still dealing with accessing God's help in time of trouble. Remember, we read from the book of Psalm number 46 and the verse of 1, where the Bible says that God is our refuge and strength. God is our refuge. In other words, whenever a crisis strike like COVID-19, we have to run to him for safety because he is our refuge. If where we are it's not safe, we need to run to God and then we shall find safety, because God is our refuge. Apart from being our refuge, the Bible says that he is our strength. Your natural strength may fail you. Your own plans may fail you. People may fail you. Actually, most of the time, people fail us because they have how far they can go as far as helping us is concerned. And that is why they you see the struggle to find the cure for COVID-19. And the only help they're able to say is make sure that you stay home, you keep a social distance, you avoid too many movements. That's how far they can go. And we need to look up to God even as we take all the precautionary measures we have been given. Therefore, this God is our strength. When you have no strength, run to God and he shall become your strength. So you are stronger than you think because God is on your side. We are strong as a nation, stronger than we think, and we shall pull out of this crisis because God is our strength as the nation. So therefore, he's not only our refuge and our strength. Now the Bible says that a very present help in trouble. A very present help. Very present, not half present. I love what the vision is saying. A very present help in time of trouble. So when trouble strikes, God is our help. Right now I've got a crisis. There's trouble all over the world. And I need you to know that God is present to give us help. Now, how do we access help from God? And that is the thing I shared last Sunday, that it is important to apply God's word. Check what scripture says. Everything you go through in life, believe me, there is a scripture in the Bible which is addressing that condition. That's why every time Jesus faced a temptation or a crisis, you heard him tell Satan, "It is written." You must know where it is written, what is written there, and how does it apply to your life, and then you're going to see change coming your way. You activate the word of God. It goes beyond a memory scripture. And then I want now to pick it up from where I left it last Sunday. I shared with you that God holds the world by the power of his word. In other words, everything is under control because of God's word. Whenever you see a crisis coming out of this world or the universe, you need to know that the same word which created the earth has the power and the ability to fix that. So we need to find the word which is addressing COVID-19. One of the things you need to really pay attention to is fear. The enemy drug would love to bring fear and panic in so many people's lives. But what does the word of God say whenever trouble strikes? That's the thing that we need to know. And when we apply the word of God, change is going to come. Today, I want to continue from where I left it last week, and I want to give you the second point on how you can access God's help in time of trouble. Number two point is that keep your faith alive. Sustain your hope. Hope and faith are two ingredients that you need right now. Let's read the word of God very quickly, and we are able to see what God has for us. I'm going to read for you Lamentations chapter 3, verse 18 to 23. The Bible records, and I read. So I say, my endurance has perished. Now Jeremiah has been enduring. Now that endurance is gone, have you ever been at a place whereby you're trying to hold on? You are trying to give it your best. You are trying to stay on, and you reach a level whereby you can't keep it up anymore. Jeremiah was at that point as well. You are not the first one who feels like throwing in the towel. You are not the first one who feels like this crisis is going to kill my business. What will become of me now? Looking at what is happening globally, what is going to happen of me? You are not the first person to feel that way. Jeremiah was there. He's saying that my endurance has perished. So has my hope from the Lord. In other words, what Jeremiah is saying, that my hope is gone. Have you ever been in a crisis whereby all your hope is gone? You are trying to hang in there, but there's no hope. Many people die in hospitals, not because of the sicknesses, but because of lack of hope. They lose hope they are going to recover, and lack of hope and faith makes them depart the earth. Now listen to Jeremiah. Remembering my affliction. In other words, it was being afflicted. They were going through a crisis as a nation. By the time the book of Lamentation was written, Israel was going through a crisis. Now he says, remember my affliction and my wanderings, the wormwood and the gall. My soul continually remembers it and is bowed down within me. If you say my soul is bowed down within me, in other words, you can say you feel low. And when you feel low, it can lead to depression or anxiety. So my soul is bowed down within me. Then I love the next sentence from Jeremiah. But this I call to mind, and therefore I have hope. In other words, Jeremiah lost hope because of the crisis they were facing as a nation. because of the affliction they went through as a nation. He tried to endure, but he reached a stage whereby he could not endure anymore. He lost hope, but he did something which brought back the hope. In case you've lost hope, it is not over yet. Hang in there, because God is our present help in time of need. And I want to assure you that our help is coming, and it's coming from the Lord. Africa shall rise again. Your nation, your family, your church, your ministry, your business shall rise again. This is what Jeremiah says. But this I call to mind, and therefore I have hope. In other words, he did something which made him to have hope. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. He reminded himself, child of God, it is important whenever trouble strikes, remind yourself of the promises of God. If God says you live up to 90, even if they point a gun on your face right now, remember he said 90. If God says you live up to 85 or 105, it doesn't matter the crisis that you face, the word of the Lord will come to pass over your life. Whenever trouble strikes, whenever you feel low, whenever your hope is gone, remind yourself of what God said. Remind yourself of the promises of God. The Bible says some trust in chariots, some trust in horses, but we will remember. We will remember. Let them trust in their horses. When it comes to war in those days, chariots and horses were their instruments they were using of warfare. They were weapons, they were the vehicles they were using to go and fight and conquer their enemies. So they had put their trust in their horses and chariots when they go to war. But David comes in and says, but for us, we may have chariots, yes, but we shall be able to remember the name of the Lord. Every time you remind yourself of the promises of God, the prophecy that you carry, it brings hope in you. And that's what is going to give us hope and faith, is when we remind ourselves what God has said. My question to you, what is it which God said over your life? What is it which God said over your family? Remember, there's a prophetic word over your nation. There's a prophetic word over this nation. There's a prophetic word over your life, over your family, over your ministry. Therefore, COVID-19 cannot defeat your life, because you're protected by the word of God. And all you need to do when hope is gone is to remember the promises of God. Let me read one scripture and then I close. Hebrews 1 verse 1. Listen to this. Now faith, this is the definition of faith. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for. They are not here, but you're hoping to have them. Now faith becomes the substance of what you're hoping for. Then the Bible says, the evidence of things not seen. Faith is the title deed that COVID-19 is gone. Faith is the title deed that healing is mine. I may be sick right now, but I am healed in the name of Jesus Christ. Now, faith is the substance of things hoped for. That's what the Bible says. Faith is the substance of things hoped for. You need faith and you need hope. And let me close it this way now, child of God. With faith, you believe what God has said over your life. And right now, I am saying and I'm declaring by faith that COVID-19 is over. That is a statement of faith. That is a declaration of faith that COVID-19 is over. It is defeated in Jesus' name. Now, with hope, I begin to wait the manifestation of what I have just declared. Let me repeat myself. If you come to me and say, Pastor, I am sick in my body, pray for me to be healed. I'm going to pray for you and say, in Jesus' name, you are healed. You may not experience the healing right now. At times, the healing may come instantly. Sometimes it may come after 4 days or 5 days. Now, between the declaration of your healing and the manifestation of what you have declared, there lies hope. So with faith, you believe that God has done it. With hope, you wait for that which you are believing God to manifest. So this is where you need hope. In time of crisis, in time of trouble, hope becomes very key. That's why Jeremiah said, I recall to mind, then I remember that the mercies of God, they are new every morning. So what gave hope to Jeremiah is the promises of God, is what God had already said. What will sustain you now in this season is you having faith in God. Never lose hope. And you're going to see God coming through for you. Now, in conclusion, Jeremiah says, his mercies never come to an end. Ladies and gentlemen, the mercies of God are new every morning. He was merciful unto the children of Israel in those days, and even us in our days, we shall experience the mercies of God, because the Bible says they are new every morning. Today, we have seen the mercies of God. And tomorrow, we are going to see the mercies of God. And the Bible concludes by saying, great is your faithfulness. Even in this situation, God is faithful. Have a great day and stay blessed.
Leadership 101 is a teaching by Pastor Machisa on personal management. This includes cultivating a better professional image, building self-confidence, how to gain a reputation for honesty and integrity, how to be assertive, and the organizing principle. The faithfulness of God, the unchanging God, are among the teaching that will bless your life. Do get in touch with us.
Remember to tune in next Sunday for any comment. If you have a prayer point, you need me to pray with you, please do get in touch with me. You need counseling or whatever question that you have, get in touch with me. Send me your message in the inbox and I'll quickly respond to that and we can pick it up from that. Have a blessed day and may the Lord bless you.
I believe you have been blessed by today's word. Remember to put God's word into practice. For details, you can reach us on +260 966 551 315. That's +260 966 551 315. Or visit our Facebook page on Eagles Christian Center Zambia. Until next time.